Hello guys, welcome to Mercedes-Benz King. This here is the all-new Mercedes-Benz S-Class S63 AMG. And in this video, I will show you the exterior, the interior, the quality inside. We will listen to the sound, and I just can't wait for it. So let's go. The S63 AMG, long version. I've got the key right here with the AMG emblem and the Alfaltenbach emblem on the backside. So let's first start with the front of the car, because it has very characteristic grille for the S-Class. The AMG emblem. It has black and chrome parts. And this middle is closed for the Distronic Plus. And a beautiful Mercedes star on the top. Furthermore, for the AMG, it has these large blacked out bumpers. Let's go over to the side. The V8 bi-turbo emblem, 4MATIC Plus, the new all-wheel drive system for AMG. So it can now turn from all-wheel drive to rear-wheel drive. Nice 20-inch AMG rims with carbon ceramic brakes and the Mercedes star. Beautiful multi-beam LED high-performance lights. Three stripes for the S-Class. I love the rims. Blacked out side mirror. You can unlock the car with your phone via Mercedes Me. The rear of the car, just like the regular S-Class, but it has large AMG exhaust. And if you look into it, you can see two exhaust pipes. Amazing looking car. S63 Mercedes star AMG. Gorgeous. It has soft closing. So as I close the door, it gets pulled in. Gorgeous interior with seat adjustments. Also for your leg extensions, the headrest, and it has the ventilated seats, heated seats. You can put the headrest down, and you can control the passenger seat with this button. Memory seats, Burmester surround sound system, and also this exclusive stereo right here. So this is the key, as I already showed you. I will just leave it right here in the storage compartment at the cup holders. Great quality with leather stitching and the Affalterbach AMG emblem right here. It has the IWC Schaffhausen clock. It's a partnership with AMG and of course Mercedes. So let's push the button and let the electronics work. So as you can see, the Burmester stereo rotates. And it has just an amazing interior. The quality is amazing. It has this carbon trim all around the interior. And these holes, it's perforated. And this is exclusive. You can also get it in the regular models, for example the S350 diesel, but of course it's an option. So let's have a look at the steering wheel. It has this large Mercedes star in the middle with beautiful stitching. And I love this flat bottom for the AMG model and flat sides. It looks round shaped, but it's actually flat from here to here. Amazing with stitching, and the side is Alcantara. So in the middle console, it has a storage space. You can actually charge your phone with this cableless charger. It has two USB slots and one SD card slot. You can also open it the other way around, like this. If I press this button, then it gets all blue. And it's amazing. So now let's have a look at the infotainment system. It's currently on the classic design display. So if I press the home button, that's the main button, you can swipe with this touchpad. To media, radio, trip. But I will go all the way to the right, to design. And I will go to progressive. And it's actually not that large of a difference with sport. It's only the colors are different. So right now I have the AMG performance statistics on the left, and on the right you can also change the view. But of course you already have the AMG performance setting right there. So on the left you can have things like navigation screen and more. You can also change the heads-up display a little bit more to the right. You can change the position. But you can also change the display. For example, the AMG Performance heads-up display. This is a little bit larger. You can also have your lap time and the speed. So let's move over to the center console with the infotainment system right here. The same goes for this system, also with a touchpad, but it's way more practical to use it with the scroller and the touchpad. So there's this vehicle settings, the telephone settings, media, radio, navigation, and the massage option. So here you can actually activate the massage. Also with hot relaxing features. It has real hot stones. Navigation. And of course the vehicle settings. Dynamic track pace. I will show you that in a driving video. Dynamic select. Engine data, vehicle data, dynamic data. So you have all three in one. That's awesome. And if you go back from here, then you have your favorite settings or your favorite fast buttons. So now let's start the engine. Hit this button right here. And listen. I will just put it into Sport Plus. You can do that with this dynamic select button right here. I can actually feel the whole car vibrating and shaking. Let's listen outside. The trunk space. It has the buttons right here. Lock and to close the boot. So let's have a look at the back seats. It is a large door, as you can see. The total length of this car is 5 meters and 25 centimeters. Amazing. The seat adjustments also here in the rear for the back seats. As you can see, there's an alarm going off in the ship, as you could hear. But let's close the door and you can really have a sense of the silentness in this car. Amazing. A lot of space. And just look at the interior. The only thing I can hear is this vent blowing air. Beautiful panoramic roof, two parts. But as you can see, I have just a lot of space. It's not even in my driver's position. It's all the way to the back. But I can actually change the seats for myself in the back, even the headrest. And the headrest is just so comfortable. Just look at this pillow. It's so soft. Amazing. So you have two cup holders. Pretty large storage space. And what is this? Of course, the ambient lighting. It's just some storage space. And there's a difference with the seats because these seats are adjustable. And so they can go all the way back. And this can pop forward. Two 12-volt chargers. You can can also sit here in the middle, but it has a pretty large tunnel, so you have to have your legs around it. But still, I'm just slightly touching the roof because it has the panoramic roof. It comes a few centimeters down, but I'm really enjoying this. So guys, as I'm sitting here in the back seats, it's just so comfortable. I'm sitting here behind the passenger seat, so I will just press this button right here. So now I can actually control the seat in front of me. So let's push it forward. And this means now I have a lot of leg room. And I'm done right now, so I just hit the button again. And now I can control my own seat. Very comfortable, especially this pillow right here. And if you want just the ultimate, like the ultimate privacy and comfortness, then you can also press this button to close the sunroof, so it gets a little bit darker. Also the sunshade here behind me. And I'm sure that now you can see the ambient lighting pretty well. And you can also close both sun screens for the windows. There's just one more panoramic roof over there that isn't closed, but that you have to control it with the button in front. So it's just amazing. You have your seat adjustments, the Burmester surround sound system, also just one for you personally, on each side actually, and it's just amazing. So I will open them all together in once. And now you have a lot more brightness inside. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you liked the video and stay tuned for more. If you would like to see a driving video of this car, just press the other video and I will see you there. So thanks for watching, guys. Bye bye.